I mean, ultimately, it will come down to your attitude.
Yeah.
16-year-old Jono from northern New South Wales was a serial runaway.
I have reported Jonathan as a missing person on 3 occasions.
They get all up in arms and I don't care. That's probably why I think that there's not much wrong, because I don't care.
I don't want to come. I'm still like 3/4 drunk.
All right, well, I'm going to come back and get you in a couple of hours.
No, you're not. You're going to go home and we're going to do this another day.
I get stoned every day.
I often ask him if he's taking drugs and he always says no.
I have a habit of telling people what they want to hear. I can be very sly.
We're now at the stage where we're really out of options.
After a week in South Africa,
I want you to do this letter for us.
A letter from his mum hit home, and host mum Portia was there to support him.
Stay with me today. Whilst you're living in your own little world, hanging around with your new city friends, enjoying the thrill and excitement of total freedom, I sit at home wondering where you are, whether you're still alive.
Wondering whether you're still alive? Wondering whether you're sleeping in the bushes? Or lying hurt in a ditch somewhere alone and frightened, unable to contact me?
I miss her.
I miss her.
And I'm sorry for everything that I did to her. And Dad, I put them through so much and I didn't even mean to.
When Portia revealed the story of her eldest son, the message finally seemed to get through.
My son was just like you.
Mm.
For more than a year, he was out there. I didn't know where he is.
Yeah.
Up until one time, I was called by one of my friends. They told me that he is in jail. I went there. I bailed him out.
Mm-hmm.
I supported him.
Mm-hmm.
But by that time,
mm.
he was discovered that he was HIV positive.
Huh.
I don't want that to happen to you.
Mm-hmm.
He's dead now. He's 6 feet under the ground. Buried him.
Back home, Jono told his mum what she'd been wanting to hear.
God, I missed you.
But I just want to say, I feel like we can start again and start from square one and just and work from there.
5 months on, has Jono really been true to his word?
I think I have changed since I've gotten back, pretty dramatically. I'm back at school.
Jonathan went back to school of his own volition, and I was actually delighted last week. He came home from school with a form that he'd completed, and he's actually decided to go into year 12 now.
Guys, right up. Playing for South Africa. Hey!
The only reason I think I hated school is because I didn't like myself. I just learnt so much in South Africa. Like, it really broadened my mind and broadened my thoughts.
Go, Jazzberry.
The relationship between me and Portia was actually pretty strong. I could tell her anything by the end of it. You know, the mother's not the enemy.
But is this just another case of Jono talking the talk?
We had a honeymoon period of about 6 weeks where he was as delightful as I know that he can be. Sadly, then, he went out one night and had too much to drink and I should imagine probably engaged in some drug taking, I don't know what, and a number of things happened on that particular night.
Jono ended up in a police cell and for the first time, his mum turned her back on him.
He was just wailing. He just was devastated that I had left him there and I had said to these police officers, you know, hands up in the air, I can't do any more. He's your problem now. And I just left him and we left him there for 10 hours.
I let myself down, as well as a lot of my family members, a lot of my friends, because, you know, they thought that I'd changed and I told them that I had because I felt that I had. But it was just, it doesn't matter if you do 400 good things and one bad thing, people are going to know you for the bad thing.
Jono is now on his last warning from his mum and the police.
juvenile justice centres.
Two months after Jono got back from South Africa, he found himself in a police lockup.
You've used up your 9 lives. If there's a situation...
His mum has drawn up a behaviour contract in a final attempt to rein him in.
I want you to sign it at the end and I'll be signing it too. Rules for living at home with mum. And if you're able to manage to live by these rules, then I'm happy for you to stay at home and continue living here.
And if I don't?
If you break the contract and do any of those things, you've got 48 hours to pack your bags. Keeping Jonathan on the straight and narrow requires so much more than conventional discipline. He needs to have a structured routine. He needs to get an education and he needs to mix with children his own age. I don't want his smoking around the house, inside or outside.
So I can still smoke, but just not around the house?
I'm not happy about it.
Okay.
And definitely no alcohol.
Yeah, well...
Absolutely no alcohol.
Yeah, I won't drink in the house.
This is my last chance. If I mess up and do something stupid and the police are involved again, that's it, I'm gone.
But having watched his behaviour and his attitude, there's been a maturing in him.
The new rules also mean Jono has to start giving back.
Do you want me to get out? No. Stay in the right direction?
No.
I'm just moving some furniture. It's part of me, it's part of my good boy deal. I have to help out with just some simple volunteer work.
This is the closest that we have been to having him on track. I'm under no illusions that Jonathan won't stuff up again because he's a teenager. I guess it's the degree of stuffing up.
It's still early days and they're waiting for me to slip up. Like, they're watching me and saying, OK, I'm waiting. But I'm not going to prove anyone right anyway.
The whole experience of South Africa has just been absolutely amazing. One-in-a-lifetime experience.
I'm coming back.
Is it?
Yeah.
I could ask you to stay long. John is very, very, very nice. He's always calling me mom, mom, mom. I like that. And it makes me feel good, very good.
In South Africa, Portia took Jono to visit an orphanage. It's home to 100 kids with no parents to complain about and no home to run away from.
I'm hoping when they are here today, they are going to think of themselves. They are going to think that we've got this opportunity, we can be good in life, and they will listen to their parents. I'm just hoping.
Portia has had an enormous impact on Jonathan's life. They formed a very strong bond, and she was able to impart a lot of knowledge to him about his life and the way he should live it and how his adverse behaviour impacts on others.
Portia reinforced the message with a parting gift.
This is from the bottom of our heart.
Love you.
I love you too, Papa.
This is the clock that Portia gave me on the last day of my South African experience.
It reminds him every morning when he gets up that it's a new day, it's time to move forward, and that time shouldn't be wasted.
Portia is in my mind every day. You know, she's like that little God figure on my shoulder saying, you know, just do the right thing. And I suppose to a degree my conscience is on the other shoulder saying, mess up.
Since signing his behaviour contract last month, Jono hasn't messed up. And for that, Lyndall says she owes at least some debt to Portia.
If I saw Portia tomorrow, there would be a lot of tears on my part. I think that she would be delighted to see how far Jonathan's come. And, you know, if there's anything that I could ever do for... Sorry. Isn't that silly?
He's been home 5 months, and already Jono's South African experience seems a long way off. He has no idea, but it's about to get a whole lot closer.
I'm feeling nervous and I'm feeling excited at the same time because I understand that Jono does not know that I'm coming. I can't wait. I'm really, like, excited. I want to see my son.
Well, since the exams are coming up, because I've got trials. Yeah, I'm going well with IT. They're very happy about that. We've got to do a database in IT, and I'm pretty much...
Oh, my son.
What are you doing?
Jonna?
Portia, this is my mum, Lyndall.
Hi, Lyndall.
How are you?
Hi, Thompson. How are you?
So lovely to meet you.
Oh, my God.
What a beautiful surprise.
What are you doing? I never, ever, ever thought that I'd ever see Portia again simply because of the fact that she's all the way over the other side of the world, and she walked in the door and my jaw almost hit the deck. It was just all the memories that she'd said to me, everything that she'd done for me, just come back and I'd been like, yep, I had a tear in my eye.
I had no idea.
They didn't tell you.
Portia has had an enormous impact on Jonathan's life, more so than any other person apart from myself. She is a wonderful human being.
From one mother to another.
Oh, no. Thanks, Lacey. Thank you very much.
I just thank you from the bottom of my heart for giving us our boy back.
To be honest, I'm not an expectee. I didn't know also what I was doing to him and what is it that I was supposed to say. But I was just trying as a parent.
I always get a little emotional when I talk about Portia. If he hadn't had that time with her, then I think he would have ended up the same way as her boy.
I've missed Portia greatly. It's just like a big hole has just been filled in.
This is very important for you to understand, to stick at school.
Yeah.
To make sure that you reach your goals. You remember you said to me, Mom, I want to be somebody.
Yeah.
And I really want you to be that.
Yeah.
I'm sure you heard one. I never thought I would come to Australia. But today I'm here to see Jono, to see how he improves his life, what is he doing about himself, if he's really going to school. And I'm very glad to hear all the news that he is really going to school. He is doing well.
That's what
they saw you before, and they must see you changing. Yeah. They must see a different person.
Yeah.
Please, just do that for me.
Yeah,
do that for us.
Yeah.
Do that for your mom, and do that for yourself. Understand?
I do, Mom.
Please, my son.
I love you.
I love you too.
I love you. I love you. Oh my God.